On this episode of AV Week, bringing AV manufacturing back to the United States, Crestron announces their virtual event and spreading AV standards around the globe. All that and more next on AV Week.
The network for the AV industry.
What are you listening to?
This
is AV.
This is AV Nation.
This is AV Nation.
This is AV Week, episode 462, recorded Thursday, July 2nd, 2020. Put love into it.
Support for AV Nation is brought to you by
Extron, industry-leading technology backed by world-class support.
And by
Peerless AV, driving technology through innovation.
This is AV Week, your weekly wrap-up of audiovisual news and information. My name is Tim Albright. I am your host. With us to discuss the news and information we have gathered for this week, first and foremost, my buddy and pal, Ms. Dawn Mead, also known as AV Dawn on the Twitters and other social. How are you, ma'am?
Very good, thanks. Glad to be back.
Absolutely. Also with us, two newbies, so Dawn, be nice to them. First and foremost, Frank Patacala from Diversified. Welcome, sir.
Thank you so much for having me.
Real quickly, I met Frank and got to hang out with him at the AVIXA Infocom happy hour a couple of weeks ago when they split everybody in a breakout room. Frank and I were the only two, and I'm
That's not quite sure.
I don't know if we smelled or what, but yeah, it was
just blame Chris.
It was a fancy. Well, it was a great time just the two of us. So yeah, it was cool. And last but not least, Joey Lloyd from the aforementioned AVIXA. Welcome, ma'am.
Pleasure. Thank you for having me.
Absolutely. I speak to Joey usually on the back end when I'm asking to interview Mr. Lobuscus, and she's telling me no, and you know, this is what you know.
It's always a no.
Dadgummit. All right, here we go. First up, from our buddies over at Commercial Integrator, Crestron, who is an underwriter of AV Nation, has announced their virtual event called Crestron Next. This two-day event, it's a showcase. It will showcase the workplace, home, and education innovation. Crestron said in the Commercial Integrator article that this is not a replacement for Masters. That in-person event moved virtual this year. Masters, if you're not aware, is a gathering of both programmers and now consultants and designers in the Crestron role. So if you're a Crestron programmer, now you're a designer, you're a dealer. Last year, at the 2019 version, I was there and able to attend and report from there. 1,200 AV professionals were in that one. This though is kind of a replacement for the trade shows. They had announced earlier this year that they were going to CEDIA. Obviously, that's not happening. They didn't. We didn't have Infocom in person in Vegas this year. Dawn, I want to start with you on this. When we're talking about manufacturer driven events like this, and Atlanta also had one during the month of June, are we going to see more manufacturer driven virtual events like this?
So I think we are, and it's not a new trend. It's new that it's virtual, but this I think is a trend that goes back to when some of the big manufacturers started building experience centers. And instead of bringing the big booth to a show, be it Infocom, CEDIA, you know, any of the big shows, they would just tell you, well, come to our experience center and we can give you the real in-depth tour and show you the detailed. But, and it is better than you might catch in a big booth. Likewise, going to an event like this might be better than the 10 minutes you can devote to them at a show, virtual or otherwise. But I've mixed feelings. Part of me says, if I am, in this case, a Crestron purchaser, and I have specific Crestron questions, we're in a Crestron ecosystem at our company, and we want to know exactly what we need to know for this, it's a fantastic event. But much like with the experience centers, as opposed to the show, if you're just a casual shopper, if you aren't locked into an ecosystem such as a Crestron ecosystem, or if you're an integrator and you have to represent several different manufacturers, I don't think something like this can replace the actual show, be it virtual or in person, because you're always going to have end users and integrators that need to see all of the above. And it's way easier to see all of the above when you can just walk three aisles over or two mouse clicks over to see the other guy. as it is to go to schlep to a different experience center on yet another business day, or devote another several hours during a business day to this virtual conference and that virtual conference. So, on the one hand, if you're already doing business with these folks and you have specific needs or specific reasons, both the in-person experience centers and these virtual conferences are fantastic. And I do believe we will be seeing more. But as a replacement for potentially shows, I still don't see that they'll have the leverage. Everybody wants to, because it's a captive audience just for their brand. But we need to look at a bigger picture as end users and as integrators. So mixed feelings there. I'm excited about it, but it's not going to replace AVIXA.
Yeah, and Frank, Don makes a good point about the experience centers, but the one thing, at least here in the States, and I always qualify that because of our size, and you also have countries like China and Russia and India sizes, Australia struggles with the size, just geography. There is an experience center. Don could be an experience to an experience center. You could be at an experience center in a relatively short amount of time. I live in St. Louis, right? And if you're not familiar with U.S. geography, right smack dab in the middle, right? I could get on a plane if I wanted to, and 3 hours either way, I could be at an experience center. That's the closeness for me. So when you look at virtual events like this or the experience center, who benefits mostly from this? Is it the dealers? Is it the end users like Don, consultants? Who is the biggest winner here for manufacturer-specific events?
So I'm going to be I'm going to give my thoughts on this. I'm a huge fan of virtual events. And, I've made no light of this. I talk about it. I'm of the opinion that this should eventually replace all trade shows. I mean, I'm being a little hardcore there, but I feel there is an opportunity here that we have missed out on many years. And I might be one of those positive guys right now who's trying to find the best out of COVID-19, but I think this has forced us to change our perspective and actually look into sales through virtual events as an alternative. I feel there's a huge market for it. I think the biggest beneficiary of these kind of events would be the end users. End users, not just from a US perspective. Ultimately, what's our goal, right? Globalization, trying to get technology out there, trying to get into the markets that are right now developing. There are huge developing markets out there. And like you said, it is not practical at all for some of these people to ever get on a plane. Or a person like myself, I'm an engineer, right? If a corporate company, anyone for that matter, I'm not talking representing my own, but in general, if they were to pick a totem pole of who gets to go to a trade show, the engineer would probably be at the bottom of it because, the companies will contact them. Crestrons, the Sonys, all these people are going to come to the engineers. But who needs to see it? The salespeople, the people who are up front in front of the clients, right? But what if I do want to see it? And that, my friend, COVID-19 has given me the opportunity to take part in Crestron and AVIXA. I don't think I would have done all of these if it weren't for a virtual event. So there's a huge opportunity here. I think what we need to do, however, and that's where the experience component of it comes into play, right? We need to expand on this. Maybe add virtual reality to this. Maybe add augmented reality to it. Take your clients on a tour of a facility virtually, Why can't we do it? And, I was talking to Lenora a couple of days ago, and I'm going to repeat myself again because this is what I'm saying. We are the experience people. We sell experiences. People come to the experience centers that we build and go, wow, this is almost like I'm there. Why can't we adopt that for ourselves? Let's do it ourselves. I think this is giving us an opportunity. Let's just go for it.
Yeah, absolutely. And Lenora there is Lenora Lane, our editor-in-chief, but also the host of our Digital Signage Digest show. And Frank was on that. So check that out if you want. Joey, two different questions, two different points of view. Obviously, you work for AVIXA, the people who put on Infocom. Before that, though, this time last year, you were working for a manufacturer. Mm-hmm. So from both points of view, what really is our manufacturers after when they go to both the in-person Infocom, when they go to the in-person ISE, but also when they put on virtual events or they join virtual events? What's the takeaway? Why are they spending the money to do either one?
I think both my colleagues today have said really wonderful points of view, and we'll start from the manufacturer side. The benefit of going to a show like an Infocom or an ISE or a Digital Signage Week is the access to people that are not in our database. We get access to more people, more of the drive-bys. It's bigger, it's more, it's all of those things. And the networking, you know, there is the connection and the ecosystem that we have between each other. And even as a manufacturer, I still need to work with the systems integrators, and there are other technologies I need to work with, and there are other places where I want to integrate. So the shows create that ecosystem, and they bring the buyer and seller together exponentially larger than any single database can. But on the opposite side of that, I worked for a manufacturer who did have experience centers, and we invested a tremendous amount of money in those. And there is something to be said about seeing it in person. Number one, anybody can get something to look good at a trade show for a day.
Amen, sister.
The long time running of something is different. There are some things additional to that that you can't see over a computer screen. And so my LED will show right now. You can't tell the difference of LED on a computer screen. You have to see it in person. You have to be able to show those things and show what those differences are and do your distances and all of those things. And so the physical experience, it means something, whether you have an experience center or not. And I think this is where, so the AVIXA side will come together and how we think the future is going to go, which is that hybrid model. You guys are right. There is something to be said about these virtual events and the digital age that we've come into. This year, I think, was my fifth InfoComm. I don't know that I've ever actually sat through a session until this year. I didn't manage to get to sit in sessions at ISE because I was running around crazy. Yeah. So the virtual nature of this is fantastic. I actually got to learn. I got to sit and listen, and it was fantastic. But there is that missing piece of the physical nature of getting on the floor and seeing all of those technologies and making those connections. And I think that's the learning piece that comes together. Everybody's asked Dave, and they've asked us, well, what did you learn? Well, I think we learned that there's more to be done to bring the person who's sitting behind the computer screen into the room with us. And how do we engage everyone together? But it's not one or the other. If anybody saw during InfoComm Connected, I had a little Twitter exchange, and I said something. I used a Taylor Swift quote, actually, somewhat embarrassingly, but I talked a little bit about how everybody can wear a crown. We can. It is our job to not only educate our buyer, but to educate our partners, and we all have to do that together in the ecosystem.
I would like to point out the fact that I didn't realize that was a Taylor Swift lyric.
Oh, yeah, it was.
And I'm very proud of that fact, just for the record. Thanks so much for watching this first segment of AV Week. To check out the rest of the episode for free, click on the link below or go by the website, avnation.tv. That's avnation.tv.